Psalms 46, 1 through 7. God is our refuge and our strength. If ever present help in trouble, therefore we will not fear through the earth shall be changed, and through the mountains slips into the heart of the sea, through its waters roar and foam, through the mountain quake at its swelling pride. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy dwelling place of the Most High. God is in the midst of her, she will not be moved. God would help us when morning dawned. The nation made an uproar, the kingdom tottered. He raised his voice, the earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. Heavenly Father, as we come here today, in this time of sorrow, Heavenly Father, we bring this daughter, a husband, the grandchildren, the sister, the brother, the relatives. Heavenly Father, we ask you to take them in your arms, Heavenly Father. When time seems hard, Heavenly Father, we ask you to give them comfort. You said that you are our comfort, Lord. Heavenly Father, we ask you to bind this family together as never before, Heavenly Father. Help them in their time of trouble and in the midnight hours when all the family and friends and the chairs are gone, Heavenly Father, when they're all alone, Heavenly Father, just wrap them in your loving arms. This we ask in your holy name. Amen.
Jesus promised. We are gathered here today for the graveside funeral of Cassandra Faye Brooks. And I would like to say on behalf of the family, we thank you all for coming. And to the family of Sandra Faye Brooks, during this time when you feel so much pain because of the loss of your loved one, the scripture offers so much comfort to those of you here today. But I want to warn you that if you're not ready to meet Jesus, you better get ready. And not only should you get ready, but you better stay ready. Because we know not the day nor the hour when our time will come. Because in the book of Matthew, chapter 25, there is a parable that talks about 10 virgins. And it says in this parable that 5 of them was wise and 5 of them was foolish. And listen, those that was foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them. But the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. And listen, the Bible says all 10 of the virgins slumbered and slept. But at midnight there was a cry made saying, "Behold, the bridegroom cometh. The bridegroom cometh." And listen, I want you to know today that the bridegroom is Jesus Christ. And at that time, the virgins was told to go out to meet him. Then all the virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. But the foolish said to them that was wise, they come up and they said, "Give us some oil, for our lamps are gone out." But the wise answered them, saying, "Not so, because I don't have enough for me and you." But he said to them, "Go to them that sell oil and buy some oil for yourself." And listen, while the foolish were gone to buy oil, the bridegroom, who is Jesus Christ, he came and listened to what happened. The wise one went in with Jesus and the door was shut. But later on, the foolish ones come back and they cried, "Lord, Lord, open the door." But it was too late. And Jesus answered them and said, "Verily I say unto you, I know you not." And Jesus is saying to those of you here today, watch therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour wherein the Son of Man cometh. So today, if you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, if I were you, I would accept him today, because tomorrow may be too late. Amen, 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 and amen.
Amen.
I need it. And now we therefore commit the body of Sandra Faye Brooks to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. Amen.
Family members, on behalf of the entire staff of McKenzie's Funeral Home, I would like to thank you for this opportunity to serve you during your time of bereavement. And today, as a final tribute to Ms. Brooks, if you would please turn your attention to your right. It's written in Psalms 55:6 that, "Oh, if I had wings like a dove, for then I would fly away and be at rest." So today, in the spirit of Miss Sandra Faye Brooks, we release the dove. Now at this time, this is going to conclude the graveside services for Miss Brooks. We're going to ask that Pastor Silcott give us the benediction, and then after that, instead of her fellowshipping with you like we would normally do, we would just ask that each other meet, you meet and greet each other with the protocol that we've all been asked to use, which is either a fist bump or an elbow bump. Thank you.
And now, we'll end. And unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you flawless before the presence of his glory, to the only wise God our Father, be glory and majesty in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Thank you.